What did you think as you watched his resignation announcement yesterday?
Well, I thought that he said to listen to women and then he talked about himself. It wasn't an apology. It was very defiant. He wanted to talk about the pain that he was going through, which is obvious, but not the pain that he's inflicted. So, I thought that was inappropriate to do that from the Senate floor, quite candidly.
Not only that, I mean, basically he said something that I hadn't heard before. He said that his apology, because he had apologized previously, at least to Leanne Tweeden, the one who has the picture of him on the USO tour, that the apology gave the false impression, he said, that he was admitting to things that he hadn't done.
Right, he was answering the president in that moment, which was, he was talking to the president. He said that it was ironic that someone like Roy Moore and Donald Trump are still in good standing. That's not irony. That's one party being better on women than the other party.
But what do you think about that? That Al Franken, well, let's talk about what happened with you. So in 2009, you were at an inaugural party for President Obama.
Yeah.
And you asked Al Franken to take a picture with you. Mm-hmm. Then what happened?
And he immediately put his hand on my waist, just grabbed a handful of flesh and squeezed a couple of times.
Your clothes?
Yes. But what I didn't put in the article was that, you know, I had just quit smoking, so I had just gained 20 pounds. I was uncomfortable just being in clothing, let alone having some lawmaker manhandle me.
And so when he put his hand on your waist and squeezed and grabbed some flesh, what did that moment mean to you?
It was shocking. I keep on describing it as cognitive dissonance, because here's someone I really admire, I really like, and he's doing something that makes me profoundly uncomfortable. And it's also, he's someone who other people like. And no one wants to hear bad things about the people they admire. And Al Franken in 2009, I mean, he was a hero. He was our 60th vote for Democrats in the Senate. He was our supermajority. It was a big deal to have him there.
So let's talk about what I think you and I were just referring to, which is, in the continuum or the spectrum of sexual harassment, is he in the same bucket as Roy Moore, what we know the allegations against Roy Moore and the allegations against Donald Trump are?
See, I think that's a false equivalence. And people have said that to me. They're like, well, he's no Roy Moore. And I'm like, well, he's no Charles Manson either. That's not what I'm accusing him of. I'm saying that he calls himself a champion of women, but he does these things that says to the women that you have no ownership over your own body, that your comfort does not matter, that I can touch you and I can do whatever I want to you, and it doesn't matter. And candidly, if he were a Republican and he was, you know, trying to kiss boys against their will, men against their will, he would have been gone 3 weeks ago.
So you think that Al Franken did deserve to lose his career for this?
It's not lose his career as much as I think the most important thing at the end of the day is that he did not parade his victims in front of an ethics committee. I think that would be very traumatic for someone who had already gone through this, who already, you know, a lot of the women didn't use their names, and I understand why. But I think going through the ethics committee process for a victim is cruel.
So he did something honorable by sparing them.
Correct.
That. And your article was also about how now is the moment for Democrats.
Yes.
That after they let the accusations against Bill Clinton go, they have some reckoning themselves.
Yes.
And this is the moment.
Right. I believe that that is the original sin, that we chose, as Democrats, we chose Bill Clinton over the women. And we keep on making that same mistake over and over again. And I believe with Al Franken, we've stopped doing that.
And so then what if Roy Moore is elected and goes to Congress? Then what can be expected?
Then I think the Republicans need to deal with the Republicans.